Good morning, children. Welcome to the online session of Sri Gokulam Public School, Guruvayur. So far in accountancy, we have discussed the meaning, definition, functions, objective of accounting. Today's class, we will discuss about the advantage and limitations of accounting. So let us move to the class and hear more about the advantage and limitations of accounting. Children, today's topic for discussion is advantages of accounting and disadvantages of accounting. Before that, let us see which all concept we have studied so far. Meaning and definition of accounting, characteristics of accounting, objectives of accounting and functions of accounting we have covered. Today, we will discuss about the advantages of accounting and limitations of accounting. Here are the 7 points of advantages of accounting. The first point is financial information about business. Second point is assistance to management. Third point is replaces memory. Fourth point is facilitates comparative study. Fifth point is facilitates settlement of tax liabilities. Sixth point is facilitates loan. And seventh point is evidence in court. The first point, financial information about business. So, a business, they know about the performance of the business during the accounting period, that is whether the business is earning profit or incurring loss, and also they will come to know about the financial position at the end of the accounting period. So, for all this purpose, we depend upon the accounting. So, it's an advantage for a business to know their performance and their position by making use of the process called accounting. Second advantage of accounting is it assists or it helps the management. In what way it will help the management? It helps the management to take decisions, to exercise control over the affairs of the business and also to make the business plans. So, for all this purpose, accounting informations are used. Next one is replaces memory. Children, it is not easy to recall or memorize all the transaction which is taking place in the organization. So, what we have to do is put it into paper. Okay. A systematic and timely recording of transaction is necessary to remember transactions. The accounting record provides the necessary information. So, whenever we are recording the information in a systematic way, so we can use the same record whenever it is required. Next point is, advantage is, facilitates comparative study. So, a systematic record enables a businessman to compare 1 year's result with those of the other years and locate significant factors leading to change, if any. So, a businessman can use his own balance sheet and compare it with the previous year balance sheet and know the strength and weaknesses and the area to be corrected. So, that is one advantage of the organization. So that he can know more about his own performance or the performance he can compare his own company's balance sheet with that of the other company's balance sheet and come to some conclusions. Okay, so that facilitates comparative study. This information helps us to make a comparative study and come up with some conclusion regarding the working of the organization. Next point is facilitate settlement of tax liability. Accounting record helps in settlement of income tax, excise duty liabilities since it is the good evidence of the correctness of the transaction. Since we are systematically recording each and every transaction of the business, so this record will be used for the settlement of income tax and other liabilities. And it can be a good evidence for the correctness of a transaction. Next point is facilitates loan. So, A loan is granted by the banks and financial institution on the basis of the growth potential, which is supported by the performance. A bank gives the loan to any organization only after inspecting the books of account. They want to know the growth potential of that company as well as the performance of the company. So when they inspect the accounting work of that organization, then only they will come to know about the performance. They will collect the information related to the performance of that organization, and then only they will grant loan to the organization. So that is one advantage of accounting. Next point is evidence in court. Systematic record of transaction is often accepted by the courts as a good evidence. So if that business had some conflict with the third party, and our accounting records is a great, or we can say a evidence, if it is properly systematically prepared, that can be accepted as a good evidence in front of a court. Okay, so that is one advantage of recording of a transaction in the process of accounting. So these are the points of advantage. Now let us move to the limitations of accounting, that is drawbacks, or we can say demerits of accounting. So here are the 5 points of limitations of accounting. The first point is accounting is not fully exact. Second point is unrealistic information. Third point is accounting ignores the qualitative elements. Fourth point is accounting ignores the effect of price level changes. Fifth point is accounting may lead to window dressing. Let us go for an explanation of these points. The first limitation is accounting is not fully exact. Although most of the transactions are recorded on the basis of evidence, such as sales, purchase, receipt of cash, yet some estimates are also made for ascertaining profit or loss. Estimates means what? You know, forecasting, weather forecasting. Is it always correct? No, sometimes it may go wrong. Same is the case with accounting. Sometimes we have to go for an estimates. So estimates is a prediction. So that prediction may sometimes go wrong also. So we cannot fully depend on the accounting. Hence, it is stated that accounting is not fully exact. Next is unrealistic informations. Accounting information may not be realistic since accounting statements are prepared following the accounting concepts and conventions. Since we know that accounting works are recorded in the books of account after following some rules and regulations and concepts and principles and conventions. But in many of these cases, some informations are such a way that they are not realistic. Okay, we cannot believe it in a real way. So, for example, under the going concern concept, children, this concept is a different chapter. So, under this concept, it is taken that business will continue for a foreseeable future. That is, the future of the business is foreseen. We cannot, it will go, work for a long period of time. That is the assumption of going concern concept. Accordingly, assets are recorded at cost and depreciation over their useful life. The assets may not be actually realizable at book value. So more about this you will have to study when we are discussing this concepts. But for the time being, you just understand that the assets which are recorded in the books of accounts are actually may not be actually realizable at their book value. Accounting ignores the qualitative elements. We know that there are quantitative and qualitative. Quantity means which can be counted, and quality means it is an abstract. Okay, so since accounting is confined to monetary matters only, qualitative elements like quality of staff, public relations, etc. are ignored. We know that in accounting we record only those transactions which are in terms of money, which have value, which have units, or which can be counted in money. So only those things can be recorded in business. So we don't record the qualitative aspect, that is quality of staff, which may sometimes directly or indirectly is related to the performance of the business. So thus we can say that it's a drawback for accounting. So accounting ignores the qualitative elements, that is one limitations of accounting. Next one is accounting ignores the effect of price level change. We know that the price of the product always changes. The land which we have purchased 10 years ago, the rate of the land in the present situation will be different. Okay, so accounting statements are prepared at historical cost or original cost. So when we that land which we have purchased 10 years back, what was the cost of that land? That will be shown in the balance sheet. Okay, so historical cost will be considered. Money as a measurement unit change in value frequently. We know that the assets, their value changes, and money value also changes. Accounting, however, presumes that value of money remains stable. Unless price level changes are considered, accounting information will not show correct financial results. So, because the price level changes are not considered, hence the accounting information will not be shown, will not be treated as a correct result. Fifth point is accounting may lead to window dressing. What is this window dressing? Window dressing in accountancy means manipulating of accounts so as to conceal vital facts, hiding the material facts or truth to mislead the potential investors. Okay, so that is what window dressing means. So they are hiding the exact figure, they are not showing the exact figure in the books of account, and they are misleading the people or users. So accounting may lead to window dressing. That is one drawback related to or limitation related to accounting. So children, now it is time to conclude today's class. In today's class, we have discussed the advantages and disadvantages of accounting. We saw that there are 7 points of advantage and 5 points of disadvantages of accounting. Now you have to read the textbook and underline these points, prepare the lecture notes as and when I am taking the class. The notes is provided to you in this session, that you can write it down in your accountancy notebook, and you have to attend the test paper provided. Write down the test paper and send it by 2 o'clock. So in next class we will meet with the new topic. Till then, goodbye.